Okay, so I'm just gonna show the garrisons set up. So if you press P, you can see the partisans here and here. These are partisans that won't actually spawn though, so I haven't put anything on any of them. But you can see I've got a garrison here, here and here. This is just the coups. I think I was eventually gonna move it down here. Over here. See that these three partisans, so I've got one there because it can be adjacent, doesn't have to be directly on it, and this one will actually look after both of them. Down here, stuff in there, I've just got some normal infantry units because I didn't beat Greece too long ago, so they're just kind of sitting there. No partisans down here, so you don't have to worry about that. You can see there's partisans there, but because I've already got units battling there, it's not really necessary. Two partisan groups here, I've got one here to protect that one, and one here to protect this one. I can actually just keep them in town. This one's in an odd spot, so you can't actually be in a town, it's kind of in the middle of nowhere. So he's there for that one. Partisans here, but because I'm actually fighting here, it's not an issue just yet. Over here we've got one protecting these two spots. Over here we're fighting, so it's still not too bad. Up here there's just got one here to protect there. The other thing for garrisons to do is they're good to hold a position while you're moving forward. So for instance, say I had units here and I want to keep pushing them forward, but I'm worried that they might try to, in this case it wouldn't really happen, but if there was a scenario where so imagine if they brought guys down all the way through here and like cut through the middle here, they could actually just go take this and take this and start gaining supplies there, and so they'll be tough to kill when they've taken these two towns. Because I've put garrisons in both of these towns, even if they do break through the line, they can't really do anything because they'll be stuck up against these garrisons, so it's always good to have garrisons kind of behind, where there's a chance that the enemy could do something. See, I've got a garrison here, in case they tried to send some sort of amphibious attack, they can't just take this town. So garrisons are just great to kind of sit behind your front and kind of protect them, even if there's no partisans there. In this case there's a few partisans, but like here there's no partisans, he's just there because over in Japan I don't think there's any partisans. Yeah, there's no partisans around here, which is good, except for like here and here. I've already got units in both of those spots, so that's fine. Here, lots of partisans around this way, so I've just got the two. I've just got that just in case if they try to send some sort of amphibious force to Hong Kong, at least it's protected. But you can see, because Japan has such little amount of units, it's really hard to kind of keep, and they don't have much resources, it's hard to keep affording to buy garrisons. So at the moment I've got a lot of areas which aren't covered by garrisons, because my main force is here, it's pretty much covering most of these partisans anyway. But another example of that is, this was mine last turn, so he actually managed to pull a unit all the way into here because I had no garrison defending there. So that's always something to be aware of. If you don't have a garrison there, which I should have, they can actually just send units all the way in. So I'll actually have to try to move this guy in, which he won't be able to deal with that. Okay, so this is now going to become a problem. That's right. But yeah, so that's the partisan side of things. As for the transport, so I just right click, don't do operate, don't do amphibious, don't do long range amphibious, click transport, yes, it'll become a T. That should be a T, not an AV or something if it's one of the others. Just left click it. If I wanted to bring these up, well, now that I have to deal with this, I'll probably actually want to bring him over. So I've double tapped it, so it'll get the max range. And then there's a railway. It's also really important with China that you go somewhere that has easy transport, because all of these dirt roads are going to take you forever to finally get to where you want to go. So the great thing about taking Hong Kong is you've now got this railroad that just leads straight there. So send that there, and then it should become a green hex. So you just click on it, and then ready to move out. So I'm not too sure why yours isn't working. It's just, yeah, I don't know. Yeah, that's pretty much it. This is just how far I've gotten. I'm just starting to attack the Dutch Indies now and starting to work on Burma. But you can see that the British already have, or actually there's some Indian armies. They've actually got armies set there, so this is going to be a bit of a tough fight. They've also got yeah, so what I did here is I actually did an amphibious strike with some special forces. Because they don't get hurt by supply, they can actually live off the land, so their supply doesn't diminish. Whereas, see, this army here, I could have sent him over here, but after landing, each turn his supply would just get to the point where he, within like two turns, he'll have zero supply and be completely useless. I actually forgot to bomb beforehand. But hopefully now with these three units, and what I would be doing is just hit, and then swap, and then hit, and then hit, well, bomb, tactical bomber, then hit, hit, swap, hit, and then within a couple of turns, I should capture the capital, which will give me all of Burma. Also, in China, eventually your bombers and fighters will become useless, because they'll start bringing in, like, the Americans and the British will start sending their own fighters, which will have better research than your own, unless you are researching to try to counteract that. But yeah, eventually their fighters will become stronger, so I just ended up sending them down here to help me with taking out these guys. That's why these guys are all the way over here, because I'm just starting to move them along. And this guy over here. So yeah, so that's basically that. So the transport thing, I'm not too sure why yours wasn't working, but hopefully that helped, just watching that. And the partisans, yeah, this is press P, have a look around. Also, always make sure when you are playing just to press S for your supply, and then S again to see where your supply is the next turn. That helps you when you want to, if you are moving units forward. It's really important that you make sure there are going to be some supplies to the place that you're moving, that you're not just going to end up with zero supplies, because as soon as you try to attack with zero supplies, But it's not going to do anything. Yeah, see, even though this is my territory, using the AV, it still has access to the land, so I'm not too sure. I'm not too sure why yours isn't working. Anyway, hope this helps.